गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स. सो यस्टरडे वी स्टार्टेड विथ न्यू ड्रग आर्सेनिक एल्बम. विल रिवाइज इन शॉर्ट एंड देन विल कंटिन्यू विथ नेक्स्ट पार्ट. सो वी हैव सीन द कॉमन नेम ऑफ आर्सेनिक एल्बम इज वाइट ऑक्साइड ऑफ आर्सेनिक. इट्स केमिकल फॉर्मूला As2O3 एंड प्रूवर इज डॉक्टर हैनेमैन. आर्सेनिक पेशेंट इज कंपेयर्ड विथ रेस ऑफ हॉर्स. Its fatal dose is 2 to 4 grains. It is used as a medicine since ancient times. It produces picture like a cholera disease. You can imagine a patient or a dying man with profuse diarrhea, vomiting, burning sensation, continuously sipping warm drinks and wants to be carried from one place to other with cadaverous odor from his body. So this sentence defines the whole arsenic patient. So Dr. Kent says that from the odor itself, you may recognize an arsenic patient as soon as he enters in his room. Constitution of arsenic patient: they are lean, thin, debilitated, having hippocratic face with dirty and waxy skin. They are very fastidious. Thermally they are chilly, and miasm, they cover sore, syphilis and psychosis. Diathesis is scrofulous diathesis. As we have already seen, arsenic acts on every organ and every tissue of the body. As it is a poison and it causes violent irritation of all tissues. By acting on GIT, it produces picture like a cholera. It increases secretions from mucous membranes. By acting on blood, it causes septic changes. Also, it acts on glands, which they indurate and suppurates. It causes inflammatory swelling with burning pain. It also causes ulcerations, which burns like fire, producing pains and discharge. By acting on skin, it produces violent itching, which is followed by burning and eruptions and ulcerations. Clinically, it is indicated in number of diseases, mainly ailments from chills, winter, anemia, abuse of alcohol, taking ice creams, cold fruits, sour beer, bad sausages, strong cheese, ptomaine poisoning, decayed food or animal matters, tobacco, abuse of quinine and sea bathing. In mind, we have seen the main feeling of arsenic is fear and insecurity. So anxiety, fear is the main feature of arsenic personality. Arsenic patient sees that world as a threatening and chaotic to them. He feels that he is very old, weak and defenseless, and that there are thieves all around him and they are ready to take advantage of their weakness. So he needs people and is dependent on them because of their weakness, but they feel that they cannot be trusted and that they are interested only in his money. However, he cannot do without them, and hence they are very careful that he should not offend them lest they leave them and go away. So he is very mistrustful, suspicious, cautious and anxious in all matters, like in money, relationships, even for health. They are having too much anxiety, that is hypochondriacal anxiety, exaggerated anxiety, that he fears that he will lose his health unless he exercises regularly. So they avoid many things which they feel which are harmful. For example, they will not eat out in restaurants. They impose many restrictions on themselves, like in diet. So he is full of anxiety. ही इज एक्सट्रीमली फियरफुल दैट ही लूज वॉट ही हैज अनलेस ही इज एक्सट्रीमली कॉशियस विच मेक देम रेस्टलेस एंड कंसेंशियस. द रेस्टलेसनेस ड्राइव हिम फ्रॉम प्लेस टू प्लेस. ही कैनॉट रेस्ट टिल द थिंग्स आर इन प्लेस. एनीथिंग दैट सीम्स आउट ऑफ प्लेस ट्रबल्स हिम. द कंसेंशियसनेस एंड केयरफुलनेस इज मैनिफेस्टेड एज अलमोस्ट कंपल्सिव नीड फॉर ऑर्डर मेकिंग देम फास्टिडियस. सो दे आर वेरी फास्टिडियस वॉन्ट्स एवरीथिंग इन ऑर्डर नीट एंड क्लीन. इवन अ पिक्चर हैंगिंग ऑन द वॉल स्लाइटली टिल्टेड मस्ट बी एडजस्टेड प्रॉपरली. सो दे आर कॉल्ड एज अ गोल्ड हेडेड केन पेशेंट ड्यू टू देयर फास्टिडियसनेस. द अर्सेनिकम कंसर्न फॉर हेल्थ एंड सिक्योरिटी कैन एक्सटेंड टू अदर्स सो दैट दिस पेशेंट्स कैन बी केयरिंग फॉर हेल्थ एंड सिक्योरिटी ऑफ अदर्स एज वेल. इवन वाइल राइटिंग दे राइट वेरी प्रिसाइजली इन वेरी स्मॉल राइटिंग फिटिंग इन मच एज पॉसिबल इन अ वेरी स्मॉल पेस. The anxiety is intermingled with fear, with suicidal impulses, with sudden freaks, and with mania. The restlessness in which he constantly moves, keeps moving from one place to other, and when thoroughly exhausted, he gets back into bed again. We have seen try of restlessness, aconite, arsenic album, rust ox. The patient is very depressed, irritable, extremely restless and anxious. There is a great fear of death and he thinks that his disease is incurable. Fear of death is marked when he is alone or when going to bed. He has weak memory with confusion in head. He suffers so much that he decides to commit suicide. There is aversion to meet people even with acquainted ones. They are very sad, tearful and having anxious mood. The dreams are also full of sorrow, fear, dreams of thunderstorm, fire, darkness and death. So dreams are also negative. So we have already seen the five important keynotes of arsenic, that is anxiety, restlessness, prostration, burning and cadaveric odor. These five are very important keynotes of arsenic. The headache, which is congestive type, there is a burning inside the head. That burning pain is relieved by heat except head complaints. What Dr. Kent says? Dr. Kent says that patient wants to keep his body in hot room but head in refrigerator. They keep the body warm and with window open to relieve the congestion of head. There is a burning as if coals of fire. We have also seen natural oil of burners. The other remedies are phosphorus and sulfur. There is a bleeding tendency, acrid excoriating type of secretions and excretions. The parts causing burning, thin bloody discharges excoriates the parts. Great prostration is persistently present. The prostration is out of proportion of degree of illness. So gastric derangements, mainly diarrhea and vomiting due to food poisoning like from spoiled eggs, fish, meat, decayed food, alcohol and due to ice cream. The stool is putrid, like decomposed flesh, putrid blood. All other discharges are also acrid, scanty, putrid, dark and offensive with cadaverous odor. Thirst is also important, thirst for small quantity of water at short interval, mainly during acute states. But in chronic state, the patient is thirstless. Gangrene. The body parts that are injured suddenly take on gangrene. A sudden inflammation tends to produce malignancies. द सर्फेस ऑफ द बॉडी इज पेल कोल्ड क्लैमी एंड स्वेटिंग फूड हैज नो टेस्ट कैनॉट बी अ स्मेल और साइट ऑफ द फूड ऑल कंप्लेंट्स ऑफ द बॉडी आर एमुलेटेड फ्रॉम रैपिंग अप एंड फ्रॉम वॉर्म्थ इन जनरल एक्सेप्ट द एक्सटर्नल कंप्लेंट्स ऑफ हेड विच आर बेटर फ्रॉम कोल्ड एप्लीकेशन एंड इन द कूल ओपन एयर All complaints are aggravated at midday and midnight, that is 12 to 2 a.m. or p.m. So, till here we have already seen, we'll continue with particulars. So, in particulars, we have to apply all the keynotes and mentals into the separate each system. So, we'll see one by one. So, first is head. Headache. Headache mainly due to ailments from exposure to cold as it is chilly remedy. Exposure to cold causes headache. Also taking ice creams. We have already seen these causations. The complaints due to exposure to cold, taking ice cream, due to decayed food, loss of vital fluids. What is meaning of loss of vital fluids? Means if there is a vomiting or diarrhea or bleeding. So this water, blood, these are our vital fluids. So loss of this vital fluids causes complaints. Also abuse of alcohol causes headache. So there is a periodic headache in all parts of the head. What is meaning of periodic? Means periodicity, specific time period. Like Monday to Monday or after every 2 days, periodicity is maintained. After same timings, headache after same particular timings. So there is a periodic headache in all parts of the head with that forehead is very congested. In headache, there is a sensation as if head would burst. And with headache, the face is flushed and hot. Headache is better from cold application and in the cool open air. There is a severe throbbing and burning type of pain which makes patient dazed and head is very hot. They feel as if skull would burst. Also with that there is a sensation as if there is a vibrations and looseness in the brain. So specific periodic headache after every 2 weeks. So after every 2 weeks there is an attack of headache. So we can say that it is also used in tension headache, used in migraine headache. So as it is periodic, we can use in migraine and also in tension headache. Aggravation, mainly headache is aggravated in the light due to motion and at the 12 to 2 a.m. or p.m. And it is ameliorated by cold application in dark room and lying with head on pillow. So next system, gastrointestinal symptoms in which the mouth is very unhealthy, easily bleeding of gums, there is a ulceration of mouth with dryness and burning heat. Remember that in each and every system, the sensation burning is constantly present. Dryness and burning is constant symptom in each and every system. So there is an ulceration of mouth with the dryness and burning heat. Tongue is very dry, clean and red. There's a stitching and burning pain in the tongue, which is ulcerated and sometimes with blue color. The meaning of blue color, that is cyanosed. Saliva is bloody. There's a neuralgia of teeth. Neuralgia means nerve pain. Nerve pain. So there is a neuralgia of teeth. They feel that teeth are long and very sore. The pain is worse after midnight and better by warmth. Also there is a metallic taste in mouth. The dryness of mouth with violent thirst. As there is a dryness, there is a violent thirst, but they drink very little water, but it is often. So thirst for small quantity and at short interval. In throat complaints, the throat is swollen, edematous, constricted and having burning, and they are unable to swallow. Useful in diphtheria, there is a formation of diphtheritic membrane which looks dry and wrinkled. In stomach, they cannot bear the sight or smell of the food. See the intensity of nausea. They cannot even bear the sight or smell of the food. There is a great thirst, drinks much but little at a time. So there is a nausea, retching, vomiting, mainly after eating or drinking. There is an anxiety in the pit of the stomach with burning pain. So there is an anxiety in the pit of the stomach with burning pain. They crave for acids and coffee. So craving in arsenic, it is for coffee and acid. There is a heartburn, gulping of acid and bitter substances which seems to excoriate the throat. Long lasting eructations. Also there is a vomiting of blood, bile and greenish mucus or brown black which is mixed with blood. So these are symptoms like gastric ulcer or CA stomach. So stomach is extremely irritable, seems raw as if torn. Patlasarka dukta. Gastralgia from slightest food or drink. There is a dyspepsia from vinegars, acids, ice cream, ice water and tobacco. See, there is a desire for acids, but it causes complaints. There is a terrible fear and dyspnea with gastralgia. Also faintness, icy coldness of water body and with great exhaustion. Malignant symptoms means it is indicated in CA stomach. Everything which is swallowed seems to lodge in the esophagus, which seems as if it is closed and nothing would pass. So malignant symptom means it is used for CA esophagus, CA stomach, CA mouth, CA tongue. So cancerous affections, as it covers syphilitic miasm also. So ill effects of vegetable diet, melons and watery fruits generally. Also with acids, they crave for milk. So arsenic is important remedy useful in cholera. Mainly causation during cholera time, mainly due to Vibrio cholerae bacteria, even taking ice creams, cold fruits, decayed food, sour beer and ptomaine poisoning. Stools are dark black. Rice watery. What is the meaning of rice watery? It gives consistency of stool, means watery, like rice water. So it is thin and watery. It is compared with rice watery. So it is important keynote symptom or pathognomonic symptom of arsenic, that is rice watery stool. So stools are dark black, rice watery, which is very offensive. Also corrosiveness of stool with intense vomiting in cholera with profound debility. So dark black, rice watery, offensive stool which causes corrosiveness and with profound debility and prostration. So during stool, there is a cutting pain in the bowel with tenesmus. Tenesmus means koyane muntopan. Koyane, that is cutting pain with tenesmus, with burning in the anus. After stool, there is a burning in anus for hours. Small offensive and dark stool with sudden and rapid prostration. Patient is anguish, restlessness with fear of death. Hemorrhoids with stitching and burning pain which aggravates on walking or sitting but not at stool. So it is important hemorrhoids with stitching and burning pain which aggravates on walking or sitting but not at the time of stools. So hemorrhoids causes difficulty in sleeping and sitting. All these burning pain which are present in gastric complaints is relieved by heat. Then we'll see next system, that is respiratory system. So in respiratory system, it is indicated for cough, asthma, pneumonia, pleurisy. So we'll see asthma. There's a loss of breath immediately on lying down. There's a loss of breath immediately on lying down. So they are unable to lie down due to fear of suffocation. See, there's a loss of breath immediately on lying down. So they avoid to lie because there's a fear of death due to suffocation. So they must sit and bend forward. So they must sit and bend forward and abduct their arms for relief. Wheezing respiration with cough and frothy expectoration. Wheezing means shitti vasla sarka, wheeze. So wheezing respiration with cough and frothy expectoration. Frothy means face like. Frothy expectoration. There's a darting pain in upper one third of right lung. You can see in the image, pain in the upper one third of right lung, which is worse after cold drinks or cold food. So whistling sound in chest due to constriction of trachea, which feels like tightening sensation in the chest. Expectoration is frothy, dark and offensive. Aggravation from 12 to 2 a.m. or p.m. that is midday and midnight aggravation. The respiratory complaints are also relieved by heat in general. Next system is cardiovascular system. There is a palpitation mainly after suppressed food sweat. So how food sweat is suppressed? Means in some people there is a excessive perspiration or excessive sweating on palms and soles. So for which they use the suppressants for sweating. Means they use some creams on soles, or for axilla sweating they use deodorants. So their sweat is suppressed. So that suppression of sweat causes cardiovascular system problems. Then we can think of arsenic. So mainly palpitation after suppressed foot sweat. Also palpitations after suppressed eruptions, means the person has eruptions and they have used some external applications, so it is gone externally, but internally it damages the cardiovascular system. So after while taking history, we ask some causation, or we found out some causations. So we stress on causations, why complaints are occurred. So it is important. So suppressed eruptions causing cardiovascular system complaints, we can think of arsenic. Heart beats more rapidly and strong mainly while lying on back. There is a sudden feeling of tightness in chest with agonizing precordial pain. So it is used in angina pectoris. What is angina pectoris? We have seen in aconite. Angina pectoris is a pain, chest pain, which starts from the left side of the chest and it can spread or radiates to left arm, neck, back. So it is radiating pain, radiates to neck, jaw, upper abdomen, shoulders and left arm. So in arsenic, that angina pain goes to the back or to the occipital region and to the neck. With the chest pain, the pulse is thread-like, incompressible and weak. Then skin complaints. The skin burns with itching. So there is a burning of the skin with itching, and he scratches until the skin becomes raw. Then it burns, but the itching ceases. See, it is alternating. Burning and itching is alternating. So when he scratches, then it burns, but itching stops. As soon as the smarting lets up a trifle, the itching commences again. Means burning stops, itching starts. Itching stops and burning starts. So it is alternate. So mainly it is at the night. So all night the itching and burning alternates. Burning for a minute and itching for a minute. Also the skin looks white, pasty with painful black color eruptions. The ulcer is so putrid that it smells like decomposing flesh. So ulcers which are very putrid means having offensive smells. So it is smell like decomposing flesh. The parts that are injured suddenly take on gangrene. So there is a sudden progress of complaints. Sore to syphilis. Means simple injury can convert to the gangrene. What is meaning of gangrene? There is a death of tissues. a sudden inflammation that tends to produce malignancy in the part. General or local dropsy with disproportionate weakness. What is meaning of dropsy? Means swelling or accumulation of water. So there is a general, means all body is swelled, or local means specific part is having swelling. So general or local dropsy with disproportionate weakness. As we have already seen, the prostration is out of proportion to the illness. Then urinary complaints. So urine is scanty, burning and involuntary. Involuntary means they cannot control the urine. Paralysis of bladder. The urine is albuminous. What is meaning of albuminous? Means urine contains albumin or white color urine. Urine contains epithelial cells, cylindrical clots of fibrin and globules of pus and blood. After urinating, there is a feeling of weakness in the abdomen. Also useful in diabetes mellitus. In female complaints, the menses are too profuse and too soon. There is a burning pain in the ovarian region. Leucorrhea. The meaning of leucorrhea means white color discharge from the vagina. So leucorrhea, which is very acrid, means acidic, causes burning, and that discharge is very offensive and thin. Pain as from red hot wires, which is worse by least exertion, which causes great fatigue, and that is better in warm room. Also useful for menorrhagia. What is menorrhagia? Means profuse bleeding or profuse menses. So useful for menorrhagia. There is a stitching type of the pain in the pelvis, which extending down to the thighs. Then extremities. In extremities, there is a trembling, twitching and spasms with weakness and heaviness, and also uneasiness in the extremities. There is a cramps in the calves, swelling of the feet. Also useful for sciatica. The meaning of sciatica is compression of sciatic nerves. The pain usually starts from hip joint and travels downward. There is a burning pains, useful in peripheral neuritis, useful for diabetic gangrenes. Ulcers on the heels, we have already seen in Allium sepa. Also useful in paralysis of lower limb with atrophy. Atrophy means the part becomes small. Akunchan pavne mhanto apan, atrophy. Then sleep. Sleep is disturbed due to anxiety and due to restlessness. They continuously moves in the bed. They must have head raised by the pillows. There is a suffocative fit during sleep, so they are having fear of lying down. Sleeps with hands over the head. Dreams are full of care and fear. streams of thunderstorm, fire, death. It feels very drowsy and having sleeping sickness. What is the meaning of sleeping sickness? Means they feel continuously sleepy in daytime also. So fever, so arsenic is very important remedy, useful in the fever, any type of the fever. It may be simple viral fever or complicated meningeal or typhoid fever. So it is useful in all types of fever. It may be dengue fever, malarial fever, any fever. So fever usually quotidian, quartan or double tertian fever. What is meaning of these words? It means periodicity. Quotidian, every 4 weeks. Quartan means every 4 days. Double tertian means after. Tertian means 3. So 3 weeks. So it mentions the periodicity. Quotidian, quartan or double tertian means periodicity. Like malaria. In malaria also, the fever is after 24 hours or after 1 week or after 15 days. So the fever which is mainly having periodicity. In aconite we have seen there is no periodicity. It is mainly used for remittent and continuous type of fevers. And the arsenic used for periodic fever. So here we can compare the aconite and arsenic. The fever anticipates every 14 days or every year. Here it is also shows periodicity. Also useful for remittent and relapsing typhoid fever. What is meaning of remittent? First, read the types of fever. There are different types of fever. Like continuous fever, intermittent fever, remittent fever, stepladder fever. So continuous means the fever is continuous without the rising of 1 degree Celsius. So it is continuous means if it starts with 99 till the end it is 99. Remittent it is also continuous, but there is a rise of 1 degree Celsius temperature. Intermittent means periodic fever like malaria. It comes after 24 hours or after 7 days. So periodicity is maintained. Stepladder fever means it rises step by step. Means at the starting, the temperature is 98 degrees Celsius. Then after some time, it is 99. Then after some time, it is 100. So like steps. So in which disease there is a stepladder fever? It is in typhoid. So it is used for remittent fever as well as for stepladder fever. So stepladder fever is mainly present in typhoid. And even if the typhoid fever is relapsing. Relapsing means comes repeatedly. Means the patient suffering every 6 months by typhoid or after every year he suffering from typhoid. We can think of arsenic. Also used for malarial fever mainly due to abuse of quinine derivatives. Yesterday I told you quinine is a anti-malarial drug. So when there is a excessive use of anti-malarial drug or when there is a no need of anti-malarial drug and patient is taken anti-malarial drug, we can think of arsenic. The other remedies used for abuse of quinine derivatives, it is China or cinchona bark. So The main timing of the fever is afternoon paroxysms, mainly 12 to 2 a.m. or p.m. means midday and midnight. So there may be sleepiness before paroxysms, means before fever comes, the patient feels sleepy. There is a yawning, stretching with malaise, debility, weakness, headache and vertigo. So these symptoms are before fever comes. And in the chill stage, there is weakness, headache and vertigo, but there is no thirst. Every fever has stages, that is chill stage, heat stage and sweat stage. So while writing, you should write with stages, that is chill stage, before chill stage what happens, and in the chill stage what happens, in heat stage and in sweat stage. So before chill stage, there's a sleepiness. During chill stage, there's a yawning, stretching with malaise, having debility, weakness, headache, vertigo, and chills without thirst. So during chill stage, the patient is thirstless. In chill stage, the nails and lips are burns. Then heat stage, there's a dry heat with thirst. So in heat stage, the patient is thirsty. So how is arsenic thirst? There's a thirst for small quantity of water at short interval. Means when the temperature rises, when patient is in heat stage, the patient is thirsty. And there's an inclination to uncover the body parts. So there is no need of covering. Then in sweat stage, the sweat is cold, clammy, sour and having offensive smell. And this sweating relieves the complaints. In sweat stage also, the patient is thirsty. So thirst is for small quantity of water at short interval. Then modalities, mainly aggravation after midday and midnight, that is 12 a.m. to 2 p.m. or 12 to 2 a.m. or p.m. Aggravation due to exertion, cold exposure, and lying on affected side or lying on back. So these are aggravating factors. Then amelioration mainly from heat, except head complaints. What Dr. Kent says, the patient wants to keep his body in hot room or warm room, but he wants to keep his head in the refrigerator. So there is amelioration from heat in general, except head complaints. Also, amelioration from hot drinks or hot application, the feels better in company. Why it is in company? Company means kunitari sobat asel ta tanna bara vatta. Why? Because they feel that they are weak, they are defenseless. So they feel that if someone is with them, they are better. Also, amelioration by rest. Relations. It is complementary to the sulfur, thuja, rustox. It antidote to camphor, carbovage, graphitis, china, hiparsulf, ipecac, noxomica. And in comparison, we have seen It is compared with aconite, compared with rustox, compared with phosphorus, compared with allium sepa, compared with nox vomica, also compared with sulfur. So in comparison, we have also seen their differences. What is the difference between aconite and arsenic? It is mainly their anxiety, their fear of death, their restlessness. In aconite, there is restlessness. It is mental as well as physical restlessness. Means even patient is having mental restlessness, and with that patient moves continuously with no relief. So there is a both restlessness, mental restlessness and physical restlessness. In arsenic, there is a mental restlessness. How? They feel very restless, anxious. In arsenic also, they move from one place to other. But what is the difference in aconite and arsenic? Aconite are very strong persons, strong and robust persons. They have their energy. But in arsenic, there is an easy exhaustion, easy fatigue. So they cannot move for long time. So they feel exhausted very easily. So they are having mental restlessness, but they cannot move for long time. And in rustox, the restlessness is physical level. There is no mental restlessness in rustox. Also, in aconite and arsenic, the difference in fever stage. The aconite, in aconite, there is a no periodicity. It is used for continuous fever. And arsenic is used for intermittent, remittent and stepladder fever. And here, periodicity is very marked. In aconite, there is also sweating, but that sweating not relieves the complaint. In arsenic, the sweating relieves the complaint. So this is difference. Also, we have seen difference between nox vomica and arsenic. What is the difference? Mainly difference at the level of fastidiousness. Both the remedies, if you open the Kent repertory, you will get three remedies for fastidiousness. One is, first number is arsenic, nox vomica, and third one is lycopodium. So how will you differentiate the fastidiousness of nox vomica and arsenic? In arsenic, they are very fastidious and very perfect. As it is a mineral kingdom, they are very perfect in their work. So, as I have given one example, the painting hanging over the wall, even if it is tilted slightly, the arsenic patient goes and kept it straight by themselves. But if they are nox vomica person, they will order to somebody that keep it straight. So this is the difference. Nox vomica is dominating persons, leadership persons. So this is the difference. Also, it is compared with phosphorus. How it is compared? Mainly in the burning. In phosphorus, the burning is present in spots, means some specific part burns. In arsenic, the whole body having burning pain. And in arsenic, that burning pain is relieved by heat. But when it is compared with sulfur, the sulfur burning, it is aggravated by heat, or it increases by heat. Even lying on bed, that warmth of bed is also aggravating factor for sulfur. So this is the difference. So here we complete the drug arsenic. It is very important drug, very very useful in day to day practice, mainly due in acute complaints like fever, कोल्ड कोलाइजा और एक्यूट गैस्ट्रोइंटेस्टिनल सिम्टम्स. सो इट इज़ वेरी यूजफुल रेमेडी. So main, you have to remember the important key notes of the arsenic for practicing. For example, if the fever patient comes to you, how will you differentiate the fever of aconite, fever of bryonia, fever of gelsemium, fever of apis, fever of antium tart and fever of arsenic? How will you differentiate? First of all, you have to see the fever with other complaints. Means clinically you have to find out why there is a fever. Means it is due to GIT complaints, due to respiratory complaints, or is there any abscess in the body or anything. So you have to first diagnose the fever. Then after that you have to ask the cause of the fever, why there is a fever. Means the patient is getting wet in the rain, pausat bhijla hai, or he has taken ice creams, or he came from the cold air, or he have taken cold drinks. So cause, you have to find out cause. After find outing the cause, you have to see the other generalities of the patient. That how is their sleep? Is they are feeling very drowsy during fever, or they are feeling sleeplessness during fever, or they are feeling sleepy but they cannot sleep? So you have to see for sleep. Then you have to see for activities. Is they are feeling very dull during fever, or they are feeling very active during fever? There are some patients who feels very active during fever, like the patient of opium, coffee. So they feels active during fever. Or there is no change in the activity. Some patient feels that there is no change. I am same before fever as we are. So you have to see sleep, activity, and third thing, you have to see that thirst. How is the thirst of the patient? Is it increased, or is it same, or it is decreased? And here on these points you have to differentiate the patients. And in some patients, you have to see the characteristic tongue of the patient. Is it coated, or it is clean, or having something prominent markings on the tongue? So if there is an arsenic patient, the fever mainly due to taking ice creams, or coming from the chill, or coming from the cold air. With that there is a thirst, with that patient is sleepy, with that tongue is very dry, and mainly the patient is very restless. He feels sleepy but he cannot sleep. He feels very restless, bechaini hote khub. So at that time we are going to give arsenic. When we are going to give bryonia, if fever patient comes, he is also having exposure to heat, or they have taken cold water when it is they are warmed, means they are coming from summer or coming from heat and taking cold drinks. With that the tongue is white coated and patient is very thirsty, means thirst for large quantity of water at long interval. So at that time, and with dryness of the tongue or dryness of all mucous membranes, you can see on the face there is a dryness, dull feeling, dry lips, the tongue is dry, hands are dry. So at that time we are going to give bryonia. And if the patient with fever, difficulty in breathing, the tongue is white, thick coated, and with that patient is thirstless, and with that patient is very drowsy, there is a desire to sleep, or he sleeps, nothing has happened with him, so sleeps for long time with fever, so at that time we are going to give antim tart. And same state like antim tart, but tongue is different, like tongue is very clean, so at that time we are going to give ipecac. If patient comes with fever and there is a thirstlessness, means there is no desire to drink water or no desire to eat, patient feels sleepy but they cannot sleep, so there is a sleeplessness, and with that patient wants to cry or feeling like crying, so at that time you can give pulsatilla. In this rainy season, if patient comes that he pausat bhijla, tacha nantar fever ala, pan dusre kai symptoms nahi, but fever with body ache and even slightest motion increases the body ache, and at that time we are going to give Rustox. So in this way we can differentiate the fever remedies. So you have to keep in mind the key notes of the remedies. So on the basis of key notes only you can give the correct remedy in the acute conditions. So in acute conditions there is no need to take full case. You have to only see the cause, the progress of the disease, and main generalities of the disease, generalities of patients like sleep, thirst, their activity, tongue, so generalities. So in this way you can practice in acute diseases. So here we complete the remedy Arsenicum album. If you have any doubt, you can ask me or call me personally. So thank you.